Let me show you how to build an AI tutor with Jotform. You won't believe how easy it is to build it. So follow me to my desktop right now. Welcome to Jotform. My name is George, and on this video, I am going to show you how to build an AI tutor. Now, the idea is to actually learn, and all we have to do is provide it either a file or a prompt, and it's super easy to do so here on Jotform. Now, this is primarily for educators and students, so you can use this to get ideas for your students, or students can actually use this to learn something, okay? Now, in this case, we have two options to get started. We can use it by uploading a file or via a prompt. Now, in this case, I'm going to show you both methods, and let's get started with a file. So what I'm going to do is upload a file, and in my case, I'm going to upload the US Constitution, which is something that is complex, which has a lot of data, and it would be something that we would need a tutor for. So this is a great option to use. So we've just loaded the PDF. Let's go ahead and continue. The AI it's going to do is drop here on Jotform, and in a few seconds, we should be getting the next option. Here we go. We just got the results, and we have three options to get started. Now, the good thing about this is that it also created a form where we could view the submissions in Jotform. So aside from learning, we'll also get those submissions to view later on. You can send this out to your students if you are a teacher. So it's a great option. So the first option that we have here is compete in real time. And let's go ahead and start this off to show you how this is going to perform. Now you have an option to set a timer depending on the complexity of the subject. In this case, I'm going to do 5 minutes, and this can be public or private. So if you set to private, then we can add the participants via email right here. Okay, in this case, I'm going to set it to public. Let's add a contestant name, and I'm going to put my name. Let's go ahead and create the contest right now. Here we go. It is now loaded up, and we have a 5 minute timer on the top. We have score, we have hint to help us, and we can also freeze. So we're going to get some special bonuses there that we can start using. Now, be aware that all the questions generated were done automatically via AI. So this is going to be super useful because you don't have to manually create these questions. And the questions are pretty good if you ask me. So we're going to get started with the first one. What is the age requirement to be a representative? Now, I'm just going to go through these so you get an idea of the questions that are going to be automatically generated. So I'm just going to answer these just for testing purposes, but you'll get an idea that it has good questions that it's going to ask based on the Constitution in this case. So for example, let's go ahead and continue. And before I finish, it might have a few more questions. Let me show you the score. So I can do a 2x score for this one. I can also use hint, which is going to give me a hint on this one. And I can also freeze. So it freezes the timer. It's just like some type of bonus here. Okay. So here we go. Let me go ahead and continue. And we're almost done. We're 90% complete. And here we go, no score. I was just testing this out, okay? So that is one of the ways that you can launch your tutor via the compete in real time. The next option is the practice makes perfect. So this is about practicing. And we're not competing with a timer like in the contest, okay? So here we go, we are going to learn. We have two options. We can fill form manually or we can fill form in chat. So let me go ahead and select this one for you. And the idea here is to, again, get the questions through a chat, but we're actually learning here. We're not against a timer. We're not using bonuses. We don't have hints, and it's kind of similar, but in a different context. Okay, so we got different type of questions, and it's a different flow and a different feeling to actually learn. So the idea here as an educator, you can understand how this is going to flow. And if you like it, go ahead and send it out to your students. And if you're a student, just kind of get this pop-up questions that you weren't expecting and you're going to learn. Okay. So that is for the practice makes perfect. And the next one is the guided learning. So let's go ahead and select this one to show you how it's going to perform. Okay, here we go. So we're going to kick this off. Let me go ahead and just select some of these so you understand what we're going to get here. So remember, this is the guided learning. So let's go ahead and select these. Here we go. And let's complete. Here we go. It is now completed. We got a score 40 out of 100. I can go ahead and retake it and learn from that to get a better score. Trying to find out where I made those mistakes. Now, once you use this and you are a teacher, you can view your results in the Jotform workspace. So inside of your workspace, we're going to have the actual system that the AI tutor was built from. So it's like the form that was used in the AI tutor. So in this case, it's the form right here, US Constitution quiz. I can go ahead and edit this form and I can modify the questions if I need to. So in this case, if I select this question, I can modify it manually. So just in case I don't like the output that I got from the AI tutor, I can make my own questions right here or add more questions if needed. So if you need to add questions, just go into the elements and you'll have several available options here. If you want to go with the same flow, you can go ahead and select the single choice to add it right here and just continue the same type of questions. Add your question right here, add the responses here, and you'll be good to go. So the idea is to optimize the tutor manually if you need to do so right here on Jotform. So there's several settings available here, several available elements that we can use for our form. We have settings here to use conditional logic. We have a thank you page. So currently it's just quiz completed. If you want to customize this, it is possible just by editing right here. And if you want to do a redirect instead of a thank you page, so you can do so right here. So maybe you can make them take a quiz and then send them to actually take the test afterwards if you have a link for that, or send them to another type of page. It's up to you if you want to use that or not. So you can have a thank you or redirect via a link. We have the publish option. If you want to share the link straight from here, you can edit the agents that were created for this. So there's a tutor for each one of these. You can create another AI agent if needed. You can share it via a QR code really easily. So all they have to do is scan it and just go straight into the AI tutor. So this is a fantastic option. Now, what about the results to see how the students actually perform, just in case you are the teacher? So in the top menu, we are gonna go into tables. And in tables, we're gonna view every single one of these submissions one by one, and we're gonna see how they actually responded. So we have two submissions, which were the two tests that we've just ran. And you can see how each one of these questions was responded. Here we go, all this, and we got a score over here. So you'll be able to see how they perform when responding these. Now in this case, we don't have a name field, so I do recommend that you add that element so you know which student responded to each one of these. So in the builder, just go ahead and add the name element so you know which person responded to each one of these. Now there's also different type of views inside of tables in case you don't like this type of view. You can go ahead and click on new tab and you can view, for example, one that is really useful is the card view. I can hit next, connect to a form. Here we go. Let's connect it to this one, continue. And I can select what I want to view. So when was it submitted? I don't want to view the questions. I just want to view, for example, the score and the last update. So in this case, I would actually add the name. I would create the card and I would view in a clear way the name, the data was submitted, the score, and the last updated in case something was updated later on. So it's just another type of view here on tables. So it's a fantastic way to build your AI tutor here on Jotform. So don't miss out on this feature and create your guides right now. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification to get notified when new videos come out. And that is a wrap.